President Ramnath Kovind visits Anzac Memorial in Sydney on the first day of his four-day Australia visit. Campaigning in full swing in poll-bound states, including Mizoram. Eid Milad-un-Nabi, the birthday of Prophet Muhammad, is being celebrated across the country. Special session of Meghalaya Assembly to be held from November 27 for passing modified resolution. And Australia defeat India by 4 runs in first T20 match at Brisbane. Good evening and welcome to the Northeast News. This is Sukanya Bharadwaj and now the news in detail. President Ramnath Kovind today visited the Anzac Memorial at Hyde Park in Sydney on the first day of his four-day visit to Australia after concluding his Vietnam tour. Kovind reached Sydney this morning, becoming the first Indian president to visit Australia. Anzac Memorial was constructed in 1934 in remembrance of the Australian Imperial Force in World War I. Kovind laid a wreath at the memorial and paid homage to those who laid down their lives in the war. Later, the president addressed the Indian diaspora. He said India is the fastest major economy in the world, adding that the confidence of global investors for India is at its peak.
Adopted country and in your professional spaces. India and Australia are multicultural societies. This shared uniqueness about the two would have been comforting to you as you settle down here, making friends, families, and associations. You have made significant contribution to the well-being of this country. As entrepreneurs, doctors, teachers, bankers, and technology experts, you are adding immense value to the Australian society and economy. We are indeed proud of your achievements and your success.
Electioneering is in full swing in poll-bound Mizoram, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. Leaders of various political parties are making whirlwind tours in different parts of the state to woo the voters. In Mizoram, political parties have stepped up campaigning across the state. Polling to the 40-member assembly will take place on November 28th. Chief Electoral Officer Ashish Kundra inspected the political polling arrangements for Brew displaced people at Khanmun yesterday. The voters are sheltered in relief camps in neighbouring Tripura. BJP leader and Union Minister Nitin Gadkari is campaigning in Jabalpur and Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh addressed a press conference at Bhopal while former Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh interacted with media in Indore in Madhya Pradesh.
उसके बावजूद हमारा भारत इनके शासनकाल में दुनिया के
Eid Milad-un-Nabi, the birthday of Prophet Muhammad, is being celebrated today. Milad Mehfils and Shairat conferences highlighting the life and teachings of the Prophet are being held across the country. Milad processions are also being organized to mark the day. President Ramnath Kovind, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu and Prime Minister Narendra Modi have greeted the people on the occasion. In his message, Kovind extended his good wishes to all fellow citizens, especially to Muslim brothers and sisters. Modi also remembered the noble teachings of Prophet Muhammad and prayed for harmony, brotherhood and peace all around. Assam Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal today released the BJP party manifesto for the upcoming panchayat election in Assam in presence of State Finance Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma and Party President Ranjit Das at State BJP party office Guwahati. Speaking on the occasion, Chief Minister said that the main agenda of BJP is to create a corruption-free panchayat. We need to build a strong democratic Assam and for that we need to uplift every nook and corner of the rural areas for the betterment of the people, he added. He accused the previous government and said that the Congress party has taken away the basic needs and rights of the common men. The Indian panorama at the International Film Festival of India was inaugurated in Panaji, Goa today. Secretary in the Information and Broadcasting Ministry, Amit Khare, inaugurated the Indian panorama in which as many as 26 feature films and 21 non-feature films will be screened. Saji Karun, directed Malayalam movie Olu, has been screened as the opening movie of the feature film category, while Karvas, directed by Aditya Suhas Jambali, was screened as the opening non-feature film. Manipur Arts and Culture Minister L. Jayanta Kumar on Tuesday inaugurated Shanghai Exposition of Art as Imphal Art Gallery. The expo, which will conclude on November 30, is organized under the aegis of the Arts and Culture Department, and during the expo, paintings, graphics and sculpture of more than 40 artists will be showcased. Speaking at the inaugural event, Minister L. Jayanta Kumar said that Imphal Art College is not only known in the state but is well known in the entire northeastern region. The art gallery will also help in informing the national and international tourists who come for the Shanghai Festival about the art and culture of Manipur, the minister added. The special session of the Meghalaya Legislative Assembly for passing of the modified resolution for inclusion of the Khasi and Garo language in the 8th schedule of the Constitution will be held on November 27th. Meghalaya Assembly Speaker Dr. Dankupar Roy on Monday informed that notification for holding of the special session will be out in a day or two. It may be mentioned that the Assembly on September 27 had unanimously passed a resolution in the connection. The new modified resolution will remove the hurdles as mentioned in the first resolution. Tripura Education Minister Ratan Lal Nath on Tuesday inaugurated the STEM Literacy Program at Agartala. The program was organized by Samagra Siksha Abhiyan Education Department in collaboration with the National Education Foundation. STEM means science, technology, engineering and mathematics, field and curriculum centered on education in the disciplines of science, technology, engineering and mathematics, that is STEM. The STEM acronym was introduced in 2001 by scientific administrators at the U.S. National Science Foundation, NSF. Speaking on the occasion, Ratan Lal Nath said that government is giving priority in quality education. He said from next year, NCERT syllabus will come into force in the school education.
In short, NCPCR. First.
In cricket, Australia defeated India by 4 runs in the first 2020 international of the 3-match series at Brisbane. India won the toss and opted to bowl first. The rain disrupted the match while Australia was at 158 runs for 4 wickets in 17 overs. A target of 174 runs was fixed for India under DLS. Chasing the target, India could make 169 runs for 7 wickets in 17 overs. One person died and 3 others seriously injured when unidentified persons suspected to be Bund supporters of All Assam Coach Rajbonsi Students Union Akrasu attacked them and set a truck on fire at Kolobari under Sarfanguri police station in Kokrajhar district last night. According to police, the assailants attacked the set ablaze a truck at Kolobari, seriously injuring the truck driver and 3 other occupants in the truck. The truck was on the way to Tejpur from Uttar Pradesh. The incident site is few meters away from All Assam Coach Rajbonshi Students Union office. The deceased was identified as truck driver Mohammed Saddam Hussein. The injured were identified as Mohammed Akin, Nahin Ali and Sanu Ali, all from Rampur district of Uttar Pradesh. Meanwhile, Akrasu, in a press meet organized today, denied their involvement in the incident. Shillong will host Shillong Endurance Motorsport Challenge from November 22nd to 24th. The event will be held at Liu Shillong, Umtinagar, and the event is being organized by Shillong Endurance Motorsport Club. Speaking to media persons on Monday, General Secretary of the club, Vicky Kharkongor, said that the event has different categories like 4x4 motocross cycle and non-gear scooters. He said that motocross is an area which attracts youths and it's a perfect platform to create awareness about HIV/AIDS.
From these two communities, the objective behind working with the marginalized group of people is to show that, you know, they also belong to the society. We're stressing more on social and reintegration, that sports could also be their way of life and to get out of drugs.
Imphal West Police has arrested the kingpin involved in the fraudulent withdrawal of cash from various banks amounting to more than 1 crore rupees from Pune, Maharashtra. Superintendent of Police Imphal West, Jogesh Chandra, stated this during a press conference held on Tuesday evening at Imphal. He said recently on October 31st, finance officer of Manipur University has reported to Sigyame Police Station stating that some unknown persons of Patel Real Estate have fraudulently withdrawn cheques amounting to 94 lakhs from the Bank of Baroda, Kanchipur. A case was registered and investigated. After investigation, the involvement of Sandeep Patel, the kingpin, was established. Accordingly, a police team led by additional SP of Imphal West proceeded to Maharashtra and with the help of Pune police arrested the accused on November 17th. The accused has been brought to Manipur and remanded to police custody. Chinhong Mac Cup football tournament final match was played on Tuesday by Thalangso. MLA Dr. Man Singh Rongpi and Chinhong Mac and also executive member of Karbi Anglong Autonomous Council Pradeep Rongpi and local BJP leaders witnessed the final match. The Chinhong Mac Cup football tournament was started from November 11th and altogether 12 teams participated in the Chinhong Mac Cup football tournament. The final match was played on Tuesday between Umsong Pho Sumsarang versus Molong Sangsir Singdoloi. The Umsong Pho Umsarang team won the match 2-1 goals and became the champion of the match. Before winding up, the headlines once again. President Ram Nath Kovind visits Anzac Memorial in Sydney on the first day of his four-day Australian visit. Campaigning in full swing in poll-bound states, including Mizoram. Eid Milad Un-Nabi, the birthday of Prophet Muhammad, is being celebrated across the country. Special session of Meghalaya Assembly to be held from November 27th for passing modified resolution. And Australia defeat India by 4 runs in first T20 match at Brisbane. That brings us to the end of this evening's bulletin. Thank you for tuning in. Namaskar.